everyone. Today we are going to discuss the topic acids and bases. Already we have learnt about this lesson. What are acids? So here acids are sour in taste. Yes. Next, when we see bases, bases are bitter in taste and soapy to touch. Next, we are going to see different activities. How we are going to find out whether the given substance is an acid or base. So for that, we need a substance known as indicator. Indicator. So here, indicator is a substance to find out whether the given substance is an acid or a base or a neutral substance. For that, we have to know there are two different type of indicators: natural indicator and chemical indicators. Natural indicators,
chemical indicators,
and
chemical
indicators. So here, natural indicators are turmeric powder. Yes, turmeric. And we are going to use the hibiscus petals,
rose petals, beetroot, madam.
So here, mango leaves, that also naturally which we can obtain from the nature. This can be used as indicators for testing whether the substance is an acid or a base. So here, from with the help of hibiscus petals and rose petals, we can prepare the litmus papers. So here litmus papers, they are also prepared naturally. Next, chemical indicators are methyl, orange and phenolphthalein. Chemical indicators. Already in the topic lesson, we have discussed all these things. Now we are going to perform certain activities to find out whether the given substance is an acid or a base. See here, we have taken some of the.
Okay, students. Now we are going to see different activities to know whether the given substances are acids or bases. So here we are going to take few substances. So now here you can see we are testing the tomato for whether it is an acid or base is present in this tomato juice. So firstly we have taken the red litmus paper and dipped in the tomato juice so that we'll see whether it is changing the color or not. So the red litmus paper, it is remaining as it is red in color. Next we'll see with the blue litmus paper. So when we are dipping the blue litmus paper, see the color change. Blue litmus paper has changed to red in color. So what can you understand from this? See, red litmus is showing red color and blue litmus is changing into red color. So here tomato, it contains acid. Yes, right? So when we have taken the tomato juice and checked with the red litmus, it is in the red color. And when we have tested with the blue litmus paper, it is changing into red color. So we can predict that, we can conclude that the acids change blue litmus to red in color. Red litmus remains red in color. See, now we are adding the chemical indicator. We have taken methyl orange over here. We are adding in the tomato juice. So now add few drops of methyl orange into the beaker so that we can see the color change. And shake it. See, it has changed to red in color. So you can say that now also we can confirm with the chemical indicator that tomato juice, it contains acid. Yes. Now once again we are going to do with the phenolphthalein. Remove that beaker and add fresh tomato juice, so that not in that. Wash it and perform next. Next, again we have taken the tomato juice. Into that we are adding the phenolphthalein solution. Already it is colorless. Now we are checking for the change in the color of the tomato juice. It has not changed its color with the tomato juice. That means when it is not changing its color, means it is phenolphthalein, it is acids. Now we'll do the activity with the bases also. One of the activity with the bases next we'll take. Here now we have taken the soap solution. Into the soap solution, first we are going to test with the red litmus and blue litmus paper. First dip red litmus paper, then blue litmus paper. So when we are dipping the red litmus paper into the soap solution, it is changing into blue color. Next, blue litmus paper, it is remaining as blue. So here we can say that the soap solution is basic in nature. It is changing into blue color. Red litmus is changing into blue color, and blue litmus is remaining as blue. Okay, now we'll test with the chemical indicators. Firstly we'll take methyl orange, then phenolphthalein. First methyl orange we'll add into the soap solution. Few drops of methyl orange. So the soap solution, when we have added the methyl orange, it is changed to yellow in color. With acids it has changed to red color. So here with bases it is changing into yellow color. So we can confirm that soap solution is basic in nature. Next we'll test with the phenolphthalein. So here we have taken the soap solution again in the beaker. Now we are testing it with the phenolphthalein indicator. So add few drops of phenolphthalein indicator into the soap solution. Just enough. Okay. So now you can see the color change. It is changing. The soap solution is changing into pink color with the phenolphthalein. So with methyl orange it has changed to which color?
Pink.
Methyl orange. Methyl orange. Yellow color. So with phenolphthalein it is changing into pink color. So we can say that the soap solution is basic in nature.
Okay. So here with the acids, when we are testing with the litmus papers, the red litmus paper is remaining as red and blue litmus paper is changing into red. And when we are testing for the bases, the red litmus paper is changing into blue in color and blue litmus paper is remaining as blue in color. So when we are testing with the chemical indicators, that is methyl orange and phenolphthalein. So here, when we are testing for acid, it is changing into red color. The methyl orange is showing changing into red color, and with the bases, it is changing into yellow color. So that we can confirm that it is an acid and it is a base. The given substance is an acid and the given substance is a base, depending upon the color change. Next, with the phenolphthalein, when we are testing for acids, it is remaining colorless. It is remaining colorless. When we are testing for bases, it is changing into pink in color. So in this manner, we can identify different substances, whether it is an acid or base. So neutral substances is not going to change any color, so that we can confirm that it is a neutral substance. For example, salt solution, sugar solution, those are neutral substances. So like this we can identify different substances as acids and bases. Okay children, thank you.